Hey there, the RV Dummy, hanging out in the RV today. And I've got a few really cool things I want to share with you. I'm just kind of kicking back. It's a beautiful day. I'm here in Salt Lake City. Yoko and I are preparing our rig to take a little trip next week, actually. We're going to be going to some local campground in, where is it going to be? East Canyon State Park, which is going to be kind of our first trip in a while since this whole quarantine craziness, weirdness started. So we're really excited. We're readying the RV, getting it. I'm cleaning it a little more today. It's going to be really cool. Kicking back today and just, I want to do this for you because I got, as I said, I've got a few really cool things to share with you today. By the way, when you're on the road, and I don't get paid for this at all. I don't get paid for anything, basically. Make sure you drink your iced tea. I love Love's truck stop whenever we have one accessible on an interstate highway. I love their iced tea. And when you get the refills, it's like dirt cheap. So I got one today. So if you have not caught the last couple episodes of my show here, I put them in a playlist. The playlist is actually called, I don't know why, but I called it season two. I don't know, because the last two episodes were kind of weird. The first one is when a couple wrote in to me, and their names were Nancy and Eddie, and they started telling me about, they wanted my advice. They were telling me about a possible ghost that may have come out of their, I'm not making this up. You can watch the episode, possible ghost that came out of their generator. Brain doesn't work too well these days. Their generator, when they, after having started for quite, having not started for quite some time. And I gave them my answers, what I thought, you know, maybe it could be or could not be. But then last episode, Yoko and I are taking a drive in our car up to around Ogden, Utah. And I started sharing some things from that video with Yoko. And she has some knowledge, some stuff that I never even knew about some things that have happened in Japan with even people that she knows about. So it's not like third hand or fourth hand. These are like stories that she actually is privy to, shared with me, and they were a little bit weird to be. I mean, I'm not saying right or wrong, or, you know, I'm not saying what I believe in, but it gets you to start thinking. And not only that, I've received a bunch of emails, comments, messages from a lot of my subscribers about those two episodes. One person in particular told me that, hey Dave, hey, look, you're getting into something that could possibly mess up your life if you're too curious. So I would advise you to stop talking about this, stop trying to explore and get on with your life, but this could mess up your life totally. So I take everything seriously that people send me, and I'm aware of that, but I'm just still a little bit curious, especially when somebody else messaged me and said that he has a, in his house, he's had like an older woman that he sees periodically appear. And this guy, I know him personally. He's not crazy. I mean, I do believe there could be things out there like that, but we'll leave it at that. This was not meant to become like a ghost series or anything like that. I was just simply answering a question, on that first episode. Next, I am just about at 10,000 subscribers. By the time you see this, I mean, I'm very close. Within the next few days, I should reach 10,000 subscribers, unless something weird happens and I have a million people that unsubscribe, which generally doesn't happen, because of course I try to keep you entertained in your RV, in your home, wherever you may be. But I just wanted to express my gratitude, because when I first started this channel, I never even thought I would be worthy enough for 500 or 1,000 subscribers. I mean, I'm just a regular guy, and I'm so humbled to the point where, I mean, I got 10,000 people that are following my channel that thought something of it, at least at some point, to say subscribe. That was really cool. So I really feel good about that. So thanks for getting me close to, and maybe very soon over 10,000. I really appreciate that a lot. Now, a couple more things I want to share with you that I think you're really going to like. Number one, as many of you know, I love music. And in the rig here, in the van, I've got two separate audio systems in the front right here. By the way, do you like the angle? I'm doing this from the front. It's really rare that I do a video for you guys from the front of my rig, sitting in the driver's seat. Usually I'm in the back, but for some reason today, I wanted to share something with you and about my audio system and something else pretty cool. So hang in there. Don't go. Don't leave because I think you're really going to enjoy this. So I've got a system in the front for sound. I've got a system in the back for sound when we're sleeping or when we're just roaming around. I just love music. And what I have dreamed of also is ultimately, I don't know if I'm going to do this or not, but I want to put a little bit about me. I still love vinyl LPs, vinyl albums. You know, when CDs came out, of course, then that went into more streaming and music coming from the computer. I kind of got rid of my turntable and didn't play any more vinyl. But in the past year or two, I've kept my collection. And I love the way vinyl sounds. And I recently, just actually a day or two ago, from a local record shop, picked up this album. Do you know what this is? If you're about my age, somewhere plus or minus, you know what this is. This is the Beatles' famous White Album from 1968. Now, this is a repressing and a remastering. This is the 50th anniversary edition. They came out maybe a year and a half ago or so. It's been remixed. The sound is awesome. And I finally picked it up on vinyl LP. And let me just share this with you. It is such a beautiful masterpiece. I mean, first of all, of course, you know, you've got the double album still on the Apple label here. They're all songs on here are just, I believe, at least in my opinion, this is one of the best albums ever to be released in music, ever. That's how much I love this. Yeah, even Revolution 9, I like. I really do. It's got a lot of songs. I can't remember how many songs exactly. But one of my favorites is, Blackbird is always a good one. You know that Blackbird singing in the dead of night? Take these broken wings. I won't bore you with my singing, but I love that song. But I love all the songs on here. But it also comes with this poster foldout with not only all the lyrics of every song, but this is the same poster that I used to have hanging on my wall in my bedroom when I was like 13 or 14 years old. They still included this. And also they included if you've ever had this album, you know exactly what I'm going to say. These are like worth $1 million to me. Pictures of the four Beatles. Now, I also had these on my bedroom wall when I was a little kid. I don't think I'm going to do it now. I don't like to put posters on my wall, not even in the van. I don't put posters, but just having these is incredible. It's an incredible feeling. I remember the day this came out back in 1968. I believe it was the fall. It was late 1968 when this came out. Back in those days, you know, when you got an album, you listened to the whole thing. So my friend Arnie, who was my next door neighbor, bought the album. I didn't have it yet. He got it like the day or the day after it came out. We went over to we were at his house. He unwrapped it. We put each record on his little turntable, sitting on his bed, listening intently to every song, every note, every lyric. And at age 13 or 14, I guess it was age 13 because it was 1968, so I was 13 and a half. This album changed my life. It honestly changed my life. And to this day, 52 years later now, because this came out in 2018, so it's 51 and a half years later, I bought this, and I still have tried to play the Beatles' White Album in one form or another, whether it's streaming, whether it's my old LP. Like, I try to play it at least once a week. That's how much this means to me. So I just wanted to share that. I hope I didn't bore you, but it's just a cool thing. You know, look, I love RVing. Sitting here even in the RV right now, by the way, I had to move it a little bit because after that video I put up about the guy that tried to break in or come onto our porch and I called him on the security camera and we called the police. Some of you saw that video. I took it down within hours after I put it up only because some of my viewers here, my friends, which I really appreciate, told me, hey, Dave, in this video, some weirdo. And yeah, you've got close to 10,000 people following you, and then another many, many, many people on YouTube. Some weirdo could figure out where you live, and they could stalk you and they could see your RV, and it's probably not a good idea. So I've actually moved my RV a little bit. I can't even disclose the location because I don't want to share with anybody and do something stupid like I did last time. But I love here, just kicking back in the RV during the quarantine has been great. And like I said, Yoko and I are ready to get out on the road next week, mid next week. It's going to be beautiful. And I will be sharing a lot of things with you once we're on the road. We're bringing our mountain bikes. We're bringing our stand-up paddle boards. I'm going to bring my skateboard. We're just going to have fun. That's what life is all about. Having fun, helping others, staying healthy, doing cool things. I'm going to be with Yoko and our cat Boo Boo, who is this year, sometime this year, approaching the age of 20. We don't know his exact birthday because he's a rescue. But it's just the three of us, and we're going to have a blast. Before I leave you today, I promise you I had a few things. Let me get one more thing I want to share with you. It's in the back, so bear with me one second while I just get out of my captain's chair right here and move my way towards the back of the van. This is pretty cool. You're going to love this. Oh my God. Oh my.
Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. All your life only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these sunken eyes and learn to see. All your life you were only waiting for this moment. Moment to rise. You were only waiting for this moment.